now for your Comixium Hypo forecast for February 13th, 2020. Well, holy crap, we have an invest in the Atlantic. Although it won't become a Category 5 like everything we're apparently seeing this year, but at least it could become Subtropical Storm Arthur in the next few days. It's a lovely story, actually. Meanwhile, in the Eastern Pacific, absolutely nothing is going on. The invest that was there died, and nothing looks to be forming anytime soon. Eastern Pacific is dead. And when it comes to the South Atlantic, I'm at a loss of words at this point. I don't even know how this happened, but Manny joined everything else in becoming Category 5 at an intensely insane speed. Another storm, Okira, formed and immediately became a Category 1 within hours of formation, so I have no idea what's going on or how warm the waters are, but it is freaking sustaining development and strong development, which is not good for anyone, especially for the people who are about to get hit by Manny. Tropical Depression 3Q has also formed two other invests. Both are probably going to form at this point. Here's a look at the Western Pacific, which now has Category 4 Hagupit, which is now making landfall in Japan, which is something you don't see in February. We also have Invest 95W, which now has a high chance of formation, and Invest 96W that somehow still exists, even though I thought we were supposed to deassign it yesterday. But apparently we're not. Apparently we're still going with the fact that there's still that tiny chance of possibility that 96W will become something in that tiny short span it has to form anything with its life. And then there's a storm everyone's talking about, Hurricane Benny, or whatever you want to call it in the Mediterranean, which now has winds of 165 miles an hour, which means it weakened, but it is still passing extremely dangerously close to France. All interested in those areas should monitor the progress of the storm, because they're about to take our croissants. Well, a bit of chaos occurred in the Australian basin yesterday, as Harold kind of had forecast changed. As you can tell, yesterday's forecast, we only had it becoming Category 1 by the time it hit Queensland. We're now predicting a Category 4. Yeah, things change. We also have an 09S, which formed from 91S. That is expected to become Category 1 before hitting northern Australia. And then there's 92S, which has a medium chance of development. So yeah, things only get crazy from here, and it's going to pretty much get much more crazier with the Australian basin. And here's a look at the North Indian wait. Where's the heck is the graphic for this? I told you all to make a freaking graphic, but no, you all freaking skipped out on your job. We don't know what happened to anything. Wait, even the Great Lakes forecast isn't here? What is with you all? Get back on your freaking jobs. I mean, come on, I split my work with freaking multiple members here, and then one of them decides to slack off when there's like two Category 5s in their control. I mean, come on. Irondro is back with another intensification phase this morning, currently a Category 2. The storm has finally began to pick up its pace again. However, the storm is expected to really get close to Madagascar's east coast as a Category 4, because we love those this year. There's still another negative side to the system, and that's related to what is now Tropical Depression 17S, which has formed in the Mozambique Channel. It's expected to remain offshore for the most part, but heavy rain from both systems could contribute to catastrophic flooding. You want to know why? Because Madagascar is literally in the middle of the freaking ocean, which means it's prone to getting bad luck, which means 2020 is the perfect year for it to be destroyed by random two cyclones. Perfectly normal, perfectly necessary. If they could survive a die, they can survive this. Looking at the storms more closely, we can see Hagupit now with winds of 130 and a pressure 938. The threat to land obviously being Japan, with a slight chance that K-pop might be affected there. There is also Manny now with winds of 190 miles an hour and a pressure of 882. Threat to land obviously being them South Americas. Meanwhile, my cat decides to interrupt me. Okay, you're not in the narration here. I don't care. I'm narrating this freaking Tropical Weather Bulletin. Anyways, Irondro is now a Category 2 with winds 100 miles an hour with pressure of 980, and it's expected to strengthen to a Category 4 before obviously passing way too close to Madagascar's eastern coast. Tropical storm warnings are already posted in the islands east of it. Oh, and then there is Tropical Depression 17S, which just exists. Obviously, I thought the Jotaro name would obviously be a Jotaro ripoff, but apparently I might be wrong. Shut up, cat. Looking at the next names, we will be seeing Arthur in the Atlantic, Amanda in the Eastern Pacific, which will probably not be anytime soon, Jang Mi in the Western Pacific, Boz in the North Indian Ocean. That name I definitely like. Emogen in Australia, Gerudo in the Southwest Indian Ocean, and Potira in the South Atlantic. I swear Gerudo needs to be living up to Jotaro's fame here. But anyway, that's all for now. Let's see what chaos we see next time in the world.